But, alright, the biggest transition, I think the biggest transition from St. Louis to Atlanta. Personally, I really don't think it was a transition, you know? Like, if you come from St. Louis, you understand how the people are, you understand how people act and how people treat each other, and you understand how hard you gotta work, you know what I'm saying, to be successful in St. Louis. When you leave St. Louis, it's a little bit easier because you already have, you know what I'm saying, been through that training, you know what I'm saying, been through that hard work, been through that exercise and that weightlifting of just people hating on you, people trying to discredit you for doing certain things. So transition was pretty easy. I mean, when you go to a different city, I mean, if you know your grind from coming back home from the crib, I mean, you pretty much can make anywhere. And I tell anybody that's from St. Louis, if you can make it in St. Louis, you can make it anywhere. If you leave St. Louis, if you're from St. Louis, you can still make it anywhere. You know what I mean? Because the world is totally different. And I just think that a lot of folks get trapped back home. I don't want to leave the hood. Fuck the hood. But the hood don't love you. You know what I'm saying? Hood represent what you when you alive, but when you dead, you're going to have a couple t-shirts with your face on them. And they're going to get washed. And they're going to use that same t-shirt to wash clothes and you're going to be forgetting about it. If you don't leave no legacy to anybody to live by, from your kids, your family, your homeboys, you're going to be forgotten. Why worry about the hood?
Okay, that's what's up. So what is the most fulfilling part of your job?
Fulfilling part? The most fulfilling part of my job is being to help people. You know what I mean? I'm getting to the point now where I'm getting older. You know what I mean? I still get hate from St. Louis. Like,
nigga, you don't represent St. Louis.
It's on me, it's Tad Donzi. And that's another thing. It's like, I represent Jay Nix. I represent Preston Youth. You know what I'm saying? I'm from St. Louis. I don't have to represent St. Louis. That's not part of my, you know what I'm saying, DNA. I'm from St. Louis. That's where I'm from. And I'm always going to be from there. It's not going to change whether you say I don't represent or not. I'm always going to be born and raised in St. Louis. But I represent my product. St. Louis is not my product. I can't sell St. Louis. I can sell this watch. I can sell FDU. I can sell this music. I can sell this clothing line. But I can sell myself. I can't sell St. Louis. So I rep St. Louis and I love it to death. But yeah, that's about it.
Okay. Last.
So going back on that most fulfilling part, it's really to help people, man. Like, you know, I get so many kids that don't have any parents or young black dudes, young black men that don't got no brothers or no daddies and they lost. So being able to help them, be like, you know what, Nick? Like, I appreciate you, bro. I appreciate you just stop and talk to me because I needed that. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to go do some wrong and I changed my mind because of what you said. You know what I mean? And just being a blessing upon people's life, man. People walk into the club like, bro, you're a prophet. I get off work, I have a message at work, I turn on, listen to your radio, and it brings in my day. You know what I'm saying? You encourage me how to be a father. I take care of your child. You know what I'm saying? Man enough for what you got to do. You know what I'm saying? I appreciate that because you gave me insight on being a dad. You know what I mean? So it's really helping people. You know what I'm saying? Black people helping black people. I don't got nothing to say about another black man. I'm going to do me. And me dogging you out or down to you is not going to give me no pluses in my life. It's only going to give me negative. God ain't going to treat me and bless me the way you would if I just decided to stop and help somebody. You know? So that's the most fulfilling part of my career. Yo, what you doing, man? Jaynix checking in. You watching XFUrlyMedia.com. You know what I'm talking about? One time for Cloud9Watch.com. My homeboy Trell and G on the down, man. Young Black Entrepreneurs. See what we're doing, right? Can't hate on that. Salute.